Good morning, everyone. How are you? What's up? It's Sunday morning. That's what's up. The sun is up. S-O-N. The sun. I don't care if it's cloudy where you are. I don't care if it's raining where you are. The sun, S-O-N, is up. That's what's up. The sun is always shining. Good morning to you this morning. I want to welcome you to the Sunday sermon. I'm Valarie Oliver, founding pastor of First Liberty Baptist Church of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. But we are not your typical Baptist church. We are not your traditional Baptist church. And I am not your traditional pastor. We are all inclusive. We welcome all. Come one, come all. We don't care what your gender expression is, who you love, who you marry, where you're from, your skin color, your background, you know, all of the petty stuff, you know, the stuff that people like to point fingers at you about and judge you. Don't you know that God looks at the heart and not the outer appearance? God looks at the heart. And so don't worry about what others think about you or what others are saying about you. We want you to know God loves you. God loves you. Amen. And so listen, this is our Youth Sunday. And so if we were in the building, we would be allowing our youth to lead us in a portion of our worship. And we would be involving them because they need to grow and they need to get accustomed to serving God in a tangible, real way. Amen. So we get back to the building, we're going to put them back to work. Amen. And so, beloved, I want to say welcome to our youth today. And I may not be able to see everybody who's on right now, but whoever is here, I just thank God for you. I want you to know that we love you, and you are welcome in this place. Without further ado, we're going to worship a little bit this morning. Now remember, I'm dealing with some new technology, so bear with me. We're going to worship. This is called Love Theory. Love Theory by Kirk Franklin. Good morning, Roz and Cheryl. How are you doing this morning? God bless you. Let us go on and worship the Lord this morning in spirit and in truth, and then we'll be back to pray. Amen. So let us pray when we get back. Watch this.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. How could you see your life was the only gift?
Help me
to see like you,
like you.
No matter what I can do.
hallelujah. Not real superheroes.
Don't pray
love like this.
Makes my heart beat.
And I promise you,
all I wanna do is make you cry.
That's why
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
I searched all over.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
You.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
That's right.
I don't wanna love nobody.
Yes, and the church saying, come on. Jesus loving you. It sounds crazy, don't it?
Hey.
Let me tell you what it means. That's why.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
I really mean it this time.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Jesus.
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Let me tell you what it does.
He saves the day.
Come on.
He will come down.
He will let you down, but
he won't let us know what superheroes do.
See, I will never find
no
a love like this.
Makes my heart beat.
Forever and a day. Let me say it again.
He
saves the day. Hey. It feels so good.
He won't let us know what superheroes do.
Yes.
The pain
of love
makes my heart beat.
For the rest of my life.
All I wanna do is make you cry.
Everybody sing.
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
You.
I don't wanna love nobody. Nobody but you.
You're the savior.
I don't wanna love nobody but you. I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Amen. Listen, the Lord came and saved the day. The Lord loves you. The Lord loves all of us. Don't worry about what you've done. Don't worry about where you've been. Don't worry about what people say. Know that the Lord loves you anyway. Amen? So with that, let us go on and pray. The Lord said, cast all of your burdens upon me, for I careth for you. And so who else loves us more than the Lord? I know we know our families love us, our parents love us, our friends love us, but nobody can love us like Jesus loves us. Nobody can love us like Almighty God, our Creator, loves us. And so who else can we run to? Where else can we go in times of need? Oh, there is much need today. There is much trouble today. Lay your burdens down, won't you? Lay them down. You don't have to carry these burdens. The Lord said, give them to me, and I'll handle them for you. And so come on and let's go before the throne of grace. And make our request made known unto God. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you this morning. We thank you for being so good. We thank you for being so wonderful, so compassionate, so merciful, so kind. We thank you for blessing us beyond what we even realize. We thank you for blessing us beyond what we even deserve. We thank you, Lord, for the blessings we can't even see. Oh, how many dangers we've walked through, back and forth, seen and unseen, that you've saved us from, Lord, and we didn't even realize it. We lied down last night and we fell asleep and slumbered in the very image of death. And your angels, you sent them to watch over us, Lord, as we slept. And they kept us safe all night long. And then this morning, Lord, for some reason, you touched us. Our eyes came open and behold, a brand new day. It is a day that we have never seen before, a day that we will never see again. But Lord, we will rejoice and be glad in it. And we thank you for this day, Lord. We'll worship you today. We'll thank you today. We'll praise you today. We'll love you today by loving one another. Oh, thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for so many blessings, we can't even name them all. Even the small blessings we take for granted. Running water, electricity, cool air when it's 95 degrees outside. Warmth in the home when it's 30 degrees outside. We thank you for clothes on our backs and shoes on our feet. We thank you, Lord, that we can put food on our tables, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all of the blessings that you have so graciously bestowed upon us. Oh God, but we will not forget those who are less fortunate. Those who had no place to lie their heads last night. Those who are not sure just exactly where their next meal might be coming from. Those down here in the South who still can't turn on the lights. Those who are still burning up in their homes and even dying from heat exhaustion because they have no electricity. Oh God, we need you, Lord. Please help those who are in need this morning, Lord. Reach out and touch, Lord, and those who are suffering all over the world, even on the East Coast and on the West Coast. And Lord, the pandemic has once again gotten out of hand. Lord, I pray that you will touch people's hearts so that they can help us do the right thing so that we can get this thing under control. You know, we've realized, Lord, that there are some things you will not do for us when we can do them for ourselves. You have given us the wisdom and the ability to be safe and to do things to put this pandemic to rest. And yet there are those who rebel against you. They're not rebelling against the government as they think they are. They are rebelling against you. You have put power in our hands to lay this pandemic to rest. If we would but get vaccinated and wear masks, we can stop the spread and stop the creation of new variants. It's in our hands, Lord. And if it doesn't change and doesn't get any better, it's not your fault. Woo, I praise you this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. You give us the ability to do things that we can, even to get wealth, even to do better for ourselves, even to pick ourselves up by the bootstraps. I heard somebody say sometimes some of us don't have bootstraps. Well, some of us don't have boots. Well, I understand that. Hallelujah. But Lord, if we trust in you, we know you will supply all of our needs according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Oh Lord, help this morning. Help us, Lord. There are those who are sick and struggling to live, touch, One touch from you, Lord, and they'll be made whole. Lord, there are people with sicknesses in their bodies. Lord, you can touch and heal, Lord, even if it's got to be through medication, even if it has to be through a doctor or a nurse or a physical therapist or a respiratory therapist. You can still heal and touch today. You are the same, but you're doing it in different ways. You're still in the healing business. You're just using your instruments, these people in your hands, Lord, to do the work in this earth. Hallelujah. And we thank you for it, Lord. Don't let us miss you when you pass us by. Don't let us miss you looking for you, thinking you're going to show up in a big old mighty powerful miraculous way when you have set people in position to help us right here, right now on this earth. You are working through them. Hallelujah. It's still you who are doing the healing. You are the ultimate healer. I don't care if it's addiction. I don't care if it's mental health. I don't care if it's a sickness in the body. You are still in the healing business today. And you do it in different ways because you have developed us so. You have advanced us so in medical and psychiatric technology, Lord, that you're working through these miraculous ways in technology today. Glory to your name. Let people know, Lord, when they don't go to the doctor, when they won't call for an appointment, when they try to do it on their own, and when they try to do it themselves, they're missing you. You're working through others. And we thank you today, Lord. We thank you just as you healed back in the day, Lord, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now we have the Holy Spirit. And we can help one another. We can heal one another. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. That's not to say that we can't still lay hands on one another. That's not to say that you won't still go back in time sometimes and heal from a touch or heal by your word. You said in your own word itself, I have sent my word to heal you. Glory, your word is alive and well and active and powerful. And it does things today in our lives and in our hearts and in our circumstances. Oh God, we thank you this morning. And Lord, we will not forget those who are bereaved. There are many. Oh, so many, Lord. Hundreds of thousands of families who have lost loved ones just over the past year and one half. Hundreds of thousands. I can't fathom in my mind how many families that is, Lord, but you know all about it. Oh, comfort them as only you can. Give them strength. Give them peace that passes all human understanding. Oh, Lord, help. It could have been to COVID. It could have been to some other illness or sickness. Lord, whatever. Touch, Lord. And Lord, no matter what the problem may be, I may not have mentioned it, but Lord, you know, everybody who's listening and everybody who will listen at a later time, you know all about their burdens. You know all about their problems and issues of life, Lord. Touch and heal whatever it may be. Finances, family issues, marital issues, whatever it may be, Lord, you know all about it. Addiction, mental health, you can still heal today, Lord. And we ask that you reach out your hand and touch and heal in the name of Jesus. And we give you thanks and we give you glory right now, even in advance. And now, Lord, as we approach your word, let us approach it with open hearts and spiritual ears, that we might hear what Spirit has to say. Those that worship you must worship you in spirit and in truth. Let us open our hearts. People don't need to hear from me. They need to hear from you, Lord. I must decrease and you increase. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable, Lord, in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. It is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. God bless you. Know that God is not only a prayer hearing God, beloved. God is a prayer answering God. Amen. And so listen, without further ado, let us go right on into the word. You know, I've been hearing over and over and over again over the past week, the same thing. And when I hear something over and over again, when I hear the same thing, I've come to know in my experience that that is the Lord speaking to me. That is the Lord trying to tell me something. I've been hearing, beloved, the word love. Love. I've been hearing it in my spirit, and I've been hearing it in other ways, but the Lord has been dealing with my heart about love. Beloved, there are some of you today who need to know that God loves you no matter who you are, where you're from, if you're a woman, what your background is, what your gender expression is, who you marry, what your skin color is, what neighborhood you live in. There are those of you who need to know that the Lord loves you. Now, hold on. Now, stick with me. I got a word for you from the Lord this morning. Come on over to Matthew, the 8th chapter, and we're going to start with verse 1. Matthew chapter 8, and I'm reading the NIV, and we're going to go with verse 1 and go on through verse 3. And so listen here, beloved. You know, this is following Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. Just to give you a little bit of a backdrop, this is following the Sermon on the Mount. And Jesus now is coming down off the mountain and going out into the different towns in the area. And so verse 1 says, when Jesus came down from the mountain, we call it the Sermon on the Mount because he sat on a slope on the mountain, on the Mount of Olives, to give the sermon. And so when he came down, large crowds followed him. Beloved, I tell you, when you got some substance, when you got something that people want to hear, when you are in the Lord and you have spent time with Jesus, people know it, and people will come to you for whatever your gift may be. It may be singing, it may be preaching, it may be teaching, it may be dancing, whatever your talent, whatever your spiritual gift is, the Lord will make sure that it makes room for you, beloved. And so Jesus taught with such power and authority that crowds followed him. Large crowds followed him. Amen. And beloved, there was a man in the crowd that came forth to Jesus who had leprosy. The man came, our text tells us, and knelt before him. Hallelujah. Now, let me tell you a little bit about leprosy, beloved. Leprosy was considered a disgusting disease in that day. It affected the skin and it caused discoloration. It was considered to be contagious with no cure at the time. And beloved, it was also considered a symbol of sin. Everybody thought back then when something happened to you, it must be because you're in sin. You're living in sin. You remember Job's friends. When all that happened to Job, his friends came around and said, "Brother, what you doing? You must be doing something to cause God to allow this to happen to you." And so leprosy, beloved, back then was considered a symbol of sin. If you had leprosy, it had to be because you had been doing something wrong or because you were a sinner. And this man had a bad case of it. Luke says in his gospel that this man was covered with it. He was covered all over his body with this leprosy. And the man with leprosy came and knelt before Jesus and said, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you have that kind of faith this morning that you know if you go to the Lord, if you call on Jesus, if you call on God, that the Lord is able and the Lord will heal you? Now, there might be a certain way God might do it that might not be to our liking. Sometimes people have to leave this world to be healed. Sometimes people have to get on out of here and do a jailbreak out of this body full of sickness and frailty and pain and get on up out of here and go on and be with the Lord and let the body go back to the dust from whence it came. Sometimes we might not like God's healing, but God will heal. God will either heal us and let us stay on this earth, or God will heal us and take us on home, whole, completely, whole. Amen. Hallelujah. Good morning, my sister Basma. How you doing this morning? Thank God for you. I'm so thankful that you have joined us this morning. God bless you. Listen here, beloved. This man asked Jesus a question. He said, "Lord, if you are willing," actually, it's not a question, it's more of a doubt or a little bit of wonder whether or not the Lord would be willing. He knew Jesus could, but he didn't know whether Jesus would be willing. He was a leper, you see. You see, and lepers were avoided oftentimes, you see. And so the man with leprosy said, "Lord, if you are willing." How many of you have that question this morning? Because of who you are, because of where you're from, or you, because of your skin color, or because of who you love or who you are, you're asking the Lord, "Lord, I need your help. I know you can, but are you willing? Are you willing to help somebody like me?" This man didn't know whether the Lord wanted to help him or not. After all, he had been rejected by everybody else. You see, but Jesus is not like everybody else. Jesus is love. Jesus is love. Some of you are wondering if the Lord is on your side today. Some of you are wondering if the Lord is willing to help you today. I stop by to tell you that the Lord is willing to help you, beloved. I stop by to tell you that Jesus loves you with a love greater than you can even comprehend. comprehend. Lord, if you are willing, this man said, you can make me clean. If you are willing. And you know what? Verse 3. Look what Jesus did. Jesus reached out his hand. Hold on now. You might not know how big this is. You might not realize how significant this is. Now, I'm going to tell you in just a minute. Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. And Jesus said, I am willing. Woo! He didn't ask any questions. He didn't say, well, what have you been doing? Well, what made you get leprosy? What kind of sin you into? What you been doing around here that the Lord has caused you to have leprosy? Where you been? Where are you when this started happening to you? Jesus didn't ask any questions. Jesus just said, I am willing. And Jesus said, be clean. Just like that. No questions. No ridicule. No criticism. No judgment. He just reached out and touched the man and said, be clean. I am willing. And immediately our text tells us the man was cleansed of his leprosy. Beloved, Jesus reached out and touched the man even before he said anything to the man. He reached out and touched the man even before he told the man he was willing. Jesus touched the man because he knew that this man must have felt ostracized and lonely and rejected, and didn't nobody want to touch him. And Jesus, that's the first thing he did, was reached out and touched him. He let the man know, listen here, beloved, I don't see you like everybody else sees you. I'm reaching out and I'm touching you. And not only am I willing, but you are healed right now. Jesus touched this man. He knew nobody wanted to touch him because of his skin condition. And not only did Jesus say, I am willing, he showed it. See, love is a verb. Love is action. Come on, English teachers. Help me here. Love is a verb. Action. It means doing something. Actions speak louder than words. We can talk all day long. We can say we love somebody all day long. When I was working up there in the mental health department at Angola, I used to hear the inmates tell each other all the time, you can make your mouth say anything. Your mouth can talk a lot of good talk. Your mouth can say anything you want it to say. But what will you do? There are those who can talk a good game, beloved, but what do they do? Do they do what they say? Jesus not only said, I am willing, Jesus showed he was willing. The first thing he did before he even said he was willing was reached out and touched the one nobody else wanted to touch. Jesus wanted to show this man compassion. Oh yeah, we serve a compassionate God. Whatever you see in Jesus, that's our creator. Whatever you see in Jesus, that's spirit. That's the divine's work. That's the spirit of God living in Jesus as a human being when he walked this earth. And Jesus was full of compassion. Luke said that the man was full of leprosy, but Jesus was full of compassion. When the leper met compassion that day, leprosy didn't stand a chance. Beloved, Jesus looked beyond himself and beyond what others would think in order to show compassion to this man. How many of us can show compassion to others, beloved? How many of us do we care only about ourselves and what we want, or do we show that we are concerned about others as well? I've seen people, beloved, stand by and watch somebody in some kind of trouble needing help and stand up there with a cell phone laughing and filming live on Instagram and Facebook. This person needs help now. This person is in some kind of trouble. This person needs an ambulance or some kind of attention, and they're standing up there with a cell phone going live. I've seen it with my own eyes. No compassion for the person that needs help. No compassion whatsoever. Only concerned about how many likes they can get. When could they could have helped this person, or try to help the person themselves, or call somebody or something to help this person in a dangerous situation? They didn't do anything. Call an ambulance or something. You see, even if you couldn't feel like it was safe enough to get involved, call somebody. But I've seen them standing up there making a mockery of the situation. I saw just the other day on Instagram, the man, poor man, was buck naked out in the street. Apparently he was having some kind of mental health crisis, or maybe some kind of addiction situation or something, and the man was running and bumping into cars and hitting his head against cars. They standing up there laughing and videoing away and just laughing. Look at this fool. Look at this fool. Oh, well, why don't you call somebody for this fool? Maybe he needs some help. I don't know nobody in their right mind who goes outside naked and starts running into cars. Call some help, see? And so, beloved, the leper was somebody who people just stood away from and stood back from. They didn't want to help them. They didn't want to do anything for them. Anyone came near a leper, according to the Levitical laws back then, they were considered to be defiled. If they came near a leper, let alone touch one of them, but even if they came near with their holier-than-thou selves, they considered themselves to be defiled, unclean. As a matter of fact, a person with leprosy had to go around. If they went around crowds of people, actually, they were discouraged from going around people. But if they did, they would have to keep their distance and put something over their faces and say, unclean, unclean, so people will know that this is a person with leprosy. Let me stay away. Ooh, that kind of sounds familiar to me today. That kind of sounds familiar by some stuff going on around here today. But that's not this sermon. And so they considered themselves unclean if they came around a leper or even touched one. They weren't supposed to go anywhere near, and here Jesus is. The first thing he does is reaches out and touches the man. Jesus not only said he loved this man in so many words, Jesus not only said, I am willing, he showed it. He reached out and he touched. He didn't say, well, I'll be back. I'm gonna check with the priest about that one. You know, I'll let you know. I'll come back and let you know. I'm kind of reluctant. You know how people are when they're reluctant to help you? Well, let me call you back on that one. Now, I'll get back. No, Jesus said, I am willing, and he touched him right then and there. Beloved, if you can help somebody, go ahead on and help them when you can. Go ahead on and help them right then and there if you can. Go on and help them, beloved. You might have a chance to save that person's life right then and there. That might be that person's last day on earth, and you may have been the last person that person saw. And you didn't help him. You held up a cell phone and made a live video. And the next thing you know, that person is no longer on this earth. You could have been the one to save that person's life. Go ahead and help them if you can. Beloved, I stop by to tell you today that God is speaking into the life of those of you who feel like lepers today. God is talking to the lepers of today. Maybe it's your black and brown skin. Maybe it's a disability. You're in a wheelchair, or maybe you walk funny with a limp, or maybe you got a learning disability, or maybe you're transgender, or you are another member of the LGBT community. Maybe you're a woman. And others have been who have been rejected and ostracized and looked down upon. That maybe you're one of the lepers of today. Jesus is telling you today, beloved, that listen here. Don't worry about what people say. Don't worry about how people treat you. Amen. Don't worry about it. Amen. Says Jesus, Jesus. Please, Jesus. Yes, Lord. And he will. And he will. Amen, Ross. And he will. Glory to God. And listen here, beloved. I want to point this out to you. And I'm coming to a close. This is the first healing recorded in Matthew's gospel account. It may not be the first miracle, but it is the first healing recorded in Matthew, the first healing of leprosy recorded in Matthew. That ought to mean something to all of us today, because Jesus' very first healing recorded in Matthew is one where he touched a person nobody wanted to touch. Where he touched a person everybody else avoided. That ought to mean something to us. The first miracle Matthew recorded, and see, Matthew was writing to Jews. You know, those who thought they were all that, you see, and looked down on everybody else. If you weren't a Jew, you were a Gentile. You wasn't nobody. You wasn't as valuable to God as they are. You see, if you were not a Jew, you didn't even belong in the church. If you were not a Jew, they didn't fool with you. You were a Gentile. Today, we would be considered Gentiles because we are not Jews. And so, beloved, Jesus, this is the first thing Jesus did. Matthew was talking to the Jews, the arrogant ones, the ones who walked with their head up in the air and looked down their noses at other people. And Matthew said, the first miracle here, Jews, the first miracle here is Jesus reached out and touched a leper. I just thought I'd throw that out there to you, Jews. Matthew is saying, I want to record this one first for you, Jews, who think you are better than everybody else, you see. Uh-huh. Oh, there's still some modern day Pharisees and still some modern day Jews, so to speak, who think they are better than others, who are arrogant and walking around. If you don't smell like them, if you don't look like them, if you don't love like them, if your skin color ain't the right color, you don't belong around here. You see. But Matthew's saying, look, this is the first miracle. Jesus reached out and touched the one nobody wanted to be around. That's a message for all of us this morning, beloved. Jesus' love for you transcends all of man's judgment against you. Jesus' love for you bypasses all of man's laws against you, beloved. Jesus' love for you is more powerful and greater than anything that anybody can bring against you. Man may say you are unclean. Man might call you disgusting, covered with sin, and you're going to bust hell wide open. Well, Jesus said, no. You're not. No, you're not. I love you just as much as I love them. I died for you just the same as I died for them. I love you just as much as I love anybody else. I don't care if it's somebody who's been in the church 80 years. I love you just as much as I love them. They might talk about you, beloved, and they might judge you. And they might not even like you. But they don't have to like you. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. That's right, sister. Don't even worry. Don't worry about it. Because the Lord loves you. And if the Lord be for you, who can be against you? Who? Last time I checked, John 3:16 says, whosoever. Didn't say straight people. It didn't say everybody who's not black and brown. It didn't say everybody who loves the way we want you to love. It didn't say everybody who's from this neighborhood or that. It says whosoever. That leaves out no one. That excludes no one. All inclusive. Let me tell you something, beloved, those of you who have left the church. I'm telling you, God has been dealing with me all kinds of ways about love this week. And to show people that God loves them. No matter what man says about them. Let me tell you something, those who have left the church because of the way you've been treated or the way you've been criticized and judged. Don't let man's faults keep you away from God. God had nothing to do with what they did. Jesus had nothing to do with the way they treated you. That's not Jesus. That's not the God I serve. Don't let what man has done to you to harm you keep you away from God. And if I would add a little bit more to that, beloved, don't let it keep you away from the church. Now, you don't have to go to the traditional church. There are many all-inclusive churches today, such as First Liberty of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. There are all kinds of all-inclusive churches who will welcome the LGBTQ plus community, affirm you and accept you and love you for who you are. And they're non-judgmental and non-critical. And they're not going to tell you that Jesus condemns you and that you are going to hell. That's a lie from hell. Ain't no truth in it. Anybody tell you is a liar and no truth in them at all. They don't know God. They don't know God as well as they think they do. Don't leave the church. Go to an all-inclusive church. Go somewhere where you can feel comfortable, because fellowship is necessary, beloved. Fellowship is important for our spiritual growth. We need to fellowship. The Lord said, don't forsake our gathering together. Let us continue. No, you ain't got to go back there and listen to that foolishness. But God has built churches and opened the doors of inclusive ministries today just for you and for me. All are welcome, of course. If they want to come worship with us, they are welcome. But there'll be no criticism and no judgment tolerated. Don't leave God and don't leave the church, because you cannot separate God from her church. We are the church. How can we separate God from us? Nothing can separate us from the love of God. And we're the church. You cannot separate God from church. You can't say, well, I'm not going to church anymore. I'm just going to worship at home. No, we got to get ourselves together. Whenever this pandemic is under control, we got to gather together, beloved, in an inclusive environment, in a welcoming environment, in a loving environment, where you will not be judged, where you will not be criticized. But you can't separate God from the church. We are the church, and we have to gather ourselves together. Whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever. And that's you, and that's me. Amen. And so, beloved, God is saying to you, actions speak louder than words. People talk a good game. They say they love you. Come on, you are welcome. Oh, but they're going to find a way to judge you when they find out you're an LGBTQ plus member. They find out you're married to the same sex. They find out something about you that they don't agree with, whether God said it or not, whether it's found in scripture correctly interpreted or not. You see, it's got to be their way or no way. You see. And so, beloved, listen here. Actions speak louder than words. Don't let people just talk a good game. Don't let people just talk to you. Jesus didn't just say, I'm willing. Jesus did something first. That was the first thing he did. He did something. He took action. Reached out and touched a leper of that day. Jesus didn't care what nobody said. He wasn't supposed to be nowhere near that man. And those who feel like they don't need to be nowhere near you, Jesus wants to be near you. Jesus wants you. Jesus loves you. Amen. When we enter anywhere, God enters with us. Amen, Roz and Cheryl. Amen, my sister. Say, that's right. That's right. That's right. Amen. God bless you, beloved. And listen here. Jesus died for you. If you're considered a leper of today because of your skin color, because you're a woman, because of the neighborhood you came from, because of who you love or your gender expression, transgender, whatever, anything that people come against, if that's you, if you're a leper of today, the Lord said, I'm going to show you I love you. I'm not just going to say it. I'm going to show you. See, because love is action. See, don't listen to what people say. Don't listen to what people say to you. Watch how they treat you. Ooh, I know I said something right there. Watch how they treat you. Don't just listen to what they say. Watch how they treat you. I'm going to say this and I'm going to go ahead and close. Jesus could have said to that man, oh, I'm willing, but I'll be back. I'm willing, but I'll be back in a few minutes in a little bit. You know, somebody tell you, I'm going to call you back, but they don't call you back. Or I'll be back. They don't come back. You know what I'm saying? You know how people do. You know, and Jesus didn't say, well, yeah, I'm willing. Yeah. But I'll be, you stay right there. I'll be back. Jesus reached out, touched that man and healed him right then and there. And then he said, I'm willing. He said, I'll show you first. He said, I'm going to show you first that I'm real. That I'm real, you see. Beloved, this is the same Jesus that I want to introduce to you today. I extend to you the invitation to Christ. Jesus loves you. Don't let nobody tell you anything different. Don't let nobody tell you that the Lord condemns you. Don't let nobody tell you that because you are one of the lepers of today, That you don't belong in church, that you don't belong in God's kingdom, that you don't belong. Don't let anybody tell you that lie. You come on to Jesus. Jesus is calling all the lepers today. All the ones who have been made to feel that they don't belong. And anyone who has never come and met this Jesus. Not the one on the wall in the traditional church, not that one. I'm talking about the Jesus who loves justice and equality, freedom and liberty for all. Equality for all, justice for all. That Jesus who loves the LGBTQ plus community just as you are. And not saying, well, yeah, I love you, but I got to change you. No, he said, I love you just like that because that's how I made you. I'm omniscient, don't you forget it. I knew who you were going to be before I knitted you together in your mother's womb. And I knew you were going to be in the LGBTQ plus community. I knew you were going to be lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, whatever. I knew you were going to be black, brown. I knew you what neighborhood. I knew all of this, and I still made you. I didn't change you. If I wasn't going to like you, I wouldn't have made you that way. Come on now. That's not the God we serve. We serve a God who is loving and genuine and caring. Come to Jesus today. That Jesus. Not the one they lying on in the church. Talking about he hates gays. They got people that are stand up outside of a gay pride festival or, you know, pride event or something like that with these old dumb signs talking about Jesus hates gays. Lying on God. Stop sinning. You are going to hell. You know, they ought to stop sinning, standing out there with them stupid signs. See, they sinning, standing out there with them signs out there, lying on God like that. Oh, yeah? You see, beloved, come to Jesus. Jesus is waiting for you. If you want more, if you want to grow more spiritually, and I'm going to be done, beloved. If you want to grow more spiritually, if you want to grow closer to the Lord, if you want more insight into the spiritual life that God has for you, if you want to know your purpose in this life, if you want to know who you really are in God, beloved, come to Jesus. I know many of you may say, well, I pray to Almighty God. I have a relationship with God. Well, if you never met Jesus, I challenge you today to come on and let Jesus come into your heart, beloved. And I'm telling you, you'll see more of what you already have. You'll see extraordinary things happening in your life that you've never seen before. I'm telling you, the Lord will make a difference in your life. Give Jesus a chance. Jesus said, I'll show you. So I'm not going to just tell you, I'm going to show you. See, come on to the Lord. Come on to Jesus. Jesus said, I'm going to give you rest. I'm going to lighten your burdens. Come on to me. And so, beloved, if you pray and ask Jesus to come and save you and deliver you from all this foolishness in this world, we want you to let us know so we can pray with you and pray for you. Call us, email us, chat with us, put a message in the inbox. However you want to reach out, beloved, we want to be there with you and for you. Amen. God bless you from the bottom of my heart. We love you at First Liberty Church. We are overcomers and so are others. Yes, Basma, we are overcomers. Amen. In the Lord. Glory to God. And so, beloved, I hope that this message has blessed your heart. I hope that you feel encouraged. I hope you feel inspired. And to those of you who feel like lepers, know that God does not see you as a leper. Jesus looked beyond all of that and reached out and touched that man right in front of the whole large crowd. In the beginning, it said a large crowd followed him. Jesus let everybody see how he touched that man, who nobody else wanted to be around. God bless you, beloved. Jesus loves you. Amen. Well, listen here. I want you to have a wonderful Sunday. We're going to have the benediction. I want you to join us on Thursday at 7 o'clock a.m. Central Standard Time for Real Talk Inspiration. Like my sister said, the Lord will show up. Yes. And the Lord will, we can help. No help is needed from anyone. That's right. When we have the Lord, we got everything we need. And if the Lord doesn't have it, you don't need it. Glory to God. Let me let you go. Listen, I love you, beloved. I'll see you next time. Be safe. Be careful out there. And listen here. Come on to Jesus. Come on. Action.